KIME, Dean cum Professor of General Medicine, Government Kilpauk Medical College, Chennai. So he has been working as medical teacher for both undergraduates and postgraduates for the past 24 years at various government medical colleges including Kilpauk, Stanley, MMC, Chengalpattu, Viripuram and Darbhanga. He has also been a consultant physician from 1991 onwards till now. Dean for 3 years at Krishnagiri, Karpur and Kilpauk. Worked as secretary selection committee for medical administrations for undergraduates, postgraduate courses in medical and dental colleges, and also for paramedical undergraduate and postgraduate courses under Government of Tamil Nadu and for institutes affiliated to the Tamil Nadu Dr. NGR Medical University for 2 academic sessions. With big round of applause, let's welcome the disclaimer I want to make. The MBBS seats
is 6,326. This is exclusive of other medical colleges run by the other universities. For example, Ramachandra University, SRM University, Samila University, like that. This doesn't come under the Tamil Nadu Medical Selection Committee. That is directly done by the whole admission is done by the Medical Counselling Committee at New Delhi. And for 7.5% have been allocated for the students who studied exclusively in the government schools from 6th standard to 12th standard. So you must have a proof for that. So that is 473 MBBS seats and 133 BDS seats. These are all, these data can change. There may be an increase provided there is a recognized MBBS or BDS seats which are increased by the Medical National Medical Commission. So that changes time to time, year to year. So the BDS for you is the government dental colleges are three. One is at the Madras Dental College and situated in Chennai. Another one is the Anamalai University, previously named. So now it's a government college. Then another one at the Pudukkottai. These are three dental colleges available. There are 20 self-financing colleges affiliated to Medical Selection Committee. This excludes the dental colleges which are affiliated to other universities. Then admissions are MBBS, medicine, as long as medicine is concerned. It's not MBBS alone, please understand. MBBS is one course, BDS another course, and paramedical degree courses are available. For example, B.Pharm, BBT, Bachelor of Physiotherapy, likewise. And paramedical diploma courses are also available. Some of the students who wants to try in medical field before going for a full-blown graduate courses, there are certificate courses also available. But then only the degree courses are can be registrable, can be employable. It is recognized one. So you have to be careful in choosing, but you are inclined to serve the human touch, human care. Then these are all the possibilities available, open. And admissions, there are two types of admissions, all India admissions and state admissions. AIMS, separate counselling by the AIMS body, there are multiple AIMS institutes are available. Again, we have to separately apply to that. And all India got 15% of the government colleges, it's done by Medical Counselling Committee. And deemed universities are also by the MCC. State counselling, the remaining 85% of the seats affiliated to Dr. Tamil Nadu, Dr. Indian Medical University are done by the State Counselling Selection Committee. The candidates can apply for above categories individually based on their NEET eligibility. So these are all the possible websites you can have. The websites, for example, Medical Counselling Committee is mcc.nic.in. And selection committee, tnmedicalselection.net. Health and Family Welfare Department, tnhealth.tn.gov.in. And Dr. HR University, tnhgrmu.ac.in. This HR University is the ultimate regulatory body for the selections made by the Medical Selection Committee of the Government of Tamil Nadu. Here, we have to follow the both the National Medical Council guidelines as well as the university guidelines. Usually both will be identical. The only thing is the candidate who has studied abroad, they should have the eligibility certificate from the major university. That point you have to remember. Some of you might have studied abroad in different universities. For example, open universities also, you have to get an eligibility certificate before applying to the medical admissions. Why I am bothered about the admission process? You should not fail in by procedural mistakes. So you have to be careful in filling up the application after studying the prospectus thoroughly. It's always better you have an elder while filling the application form. And you can have ready with the what are the possible documents. I am going to enlist the possible documents which you can keep it ready. the official websites for notifications and announcements. Sometimes the YouTubers also can give you very good guidelines, but for official reference, you always refer the official websites. That is my humble request to all of you, the parents as well as the candidates. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare Department is mohfw.gov.in. National Medical Commission, www.nmc.org.in. National Board of Examination, npe.edu.in. National Board of Examinations are more relevant for the postgraduate courses in the medical education. And National Testing Agency, I think you might have applied for the NEET through this only. So this is another website you might be very familiar. There are two types of
higher degree
MBBS
or MD MS equipped
பண்ணி ஆச்சார் some of the special categories, for example 7.5 XR women are persons with disabilities. These three categories, the first day I can say the first day of selection by the government of Tamil Nadu happens offline. Other for the remaining categories is online only. Regarding the sports category, you have to apply to that. The sports authority only will give the clearance of the eligible candidate list to the selection committee. And selection committee, depending upon the rank released by the Tamil Nadu Medical Selection Committee, they will allot, the seats will be allotted as per the choices. So the application process for as long as MBBS and BDS is like this. Based on the needs of the character of the year, all conditions the candidate should be fulfilling as mentioned in their prospectus. The rules of reservation depending upon the category for which the candidate applies and the government quota, and there are management quota also available. In the self-financing colleges, some of the self-financing colleges might have given entire seats to the government quota, especially in the natural courses. Sometimes or depending upon the required government quota. So there are multiple seats available and management quota that is reserved for them, but for that also the selection should be online counselling and special categories just now I have mentioned for previously. And I'm just going through that. Meanwhile, you can stop me anytime. You can ask any questions related to the admission process. I will be able to guide you for that. This is one flowchart given in the last year's prospectus. You can go to the selection committee website and you can download another UG courses. The prospectus are available. You can study and then make it ready also for yourself. There may not be much of amendments unless the huge amendments are happening by the NMC or the university. Otherwise, the prospectus almost remains the same. So this is, there will be the 4 rounds, first round, second round, third round, and the last one is called the stay round. So these 4 rounds, the first round there may not be much problems. The second round only, that maybe sometimes the students opt to shift to the other courses, other colleges, then you have to choose it then. That is one point. And third, this is the process of application. This also is given in the prospect. I just copied and I am just giving you the list. The document needed, this you have to keep it ready with you. The NEET UG admit card and NEET UG scorecard. This scoring, usually the selection committee collects the scorecard from the National Testing Agency. So they will be matching the scorecard submitted by the candidate, and unless they both are matching, the candidate will not be included in the rank list. So you can be very careful in attaching the scorecard. And 12th mark sheet, 11th mark sheet, 10th mark sheet as per the prospectus. Sometimes they may not ask all these things. Please is given that you have at the notes, and Aadhaar card is there, very essential certificate. I hope all of you might be having the Aadhaar card for that matter. And minority certificate, especially when a candidate wants to apply to the institutions recognized as a minority institutions, that certificate, only few minorities are classified. Christian minority, Telugu minority, and Malayalam minority. Likewise, there may be added institutions depending upon this current, that when the prospectus is released, we must have that things. And eligibility certificate, as I already mentioned, if the candidate has studied abroad or in the open university or different course other than state and central course, you may require the eligibility certificate, which we have to apply to the Tamil Nadu Medical University website, and you can download it off the face and pay some fees. And the document needed after the parents, the community certificate to utilize the communal reservation, either one of the certificate or non-literate parents can produce non-graduate certificate, either one of the Aadhaar card, driving license or voter ID, driving license, and this any one of them have to be applied, and ration card or passport. And document needed for special categories, minority certificate from the Tahsildar or competent revenue authority, and NRA, embassy letter, and board certificate that has to be attested by the embassy official, and bank statement. Here again, these certificates will be sent to the concerned authorities for verification. So genuine certificate alone should be attached to the application. Otherwise, there may be a rejection of the application process. And for OCI card holders, overseas citizens of India card holders, they have to produce that number. These are the few documents when you apply under the special category. Fee structure, always it's the government medical colleges are very less when compared to the other institutes. Or application fees, in time to time it changes. Please remember, these are all the things which may be collected during the application process. Security deposit and tuition fees. Before getting the admin card, you have to pay the tuition fees. Then only you can get the admin card printed or you download it from the website. So discontinuation fees, when you want to discontinue the course for better courses, then there will be a discontinuation course depending upon which job of the counselling you are, as per the prospectus. And there is, please remember, there is none of these fees for the 7.5% government quota. The entire education, hostel and mess, everything is covered by the government of Tamil Nadu, whatever the colleges you are studying, but it should be under the government quota. And similarly, government quota is there in the self-financing institute also. All the things, the tuition fees will be different according to the different institutes. So you have to read the prospectus before choosing a particular institute. Sometimes after choosing it, you cannot go back and you cannot ask for a reduction in the tuition fees. These are all the things which we have to. I have seen many candidates and parents coming to us with the tears that wrongly we have selected that college. So such things, such procedural mistakes, please be avoid during the application process. This is the one thing I want to stress on that, because that cannot be reverted back. So fee structure in management quota in the self-financing colleges, again the same application fees, but the amount will be totally different. Security deposit, tuition fees. Because I have not mentioned this here, because the last year's fee structures may not be applicable this year. But you can have a proportionate fee structure as per the management prospectus. There are two prospectus available for MBBS and BDS together only. Government prospectus and for management prospectus. So please download, it is in there. PDF form, it's freely downloadable. You can download it and keep it for your reference. You, at your leisure time, you can study about that. And for the NRA quota also, there are different types of fees in different colleges. Mostly it may be crossing 20 lakhs per seat per annum. place your number. NRI labs quota is some of the NRI seats may not get filled during the different rounds of counselling. That round, depending upon the college request, it will be converted into NRI labs quota. That NRI labs quota tuition fees may be little less, few lakhs is less than the NRI fees. And discontinuation fees for any management quota will be there depending upon the fees. All these fees are determined by fee fixation committee headed by retired honorable judge of the High Court. So that fee structure only, it will be incorporated into the prospectus by the government of Tamil Nadu. So the phases, first phase, second phase, third phase and last phase. So you can please study about the first phase, second phase alone for a time being. Then you can go to the next phase if you do not get the seats in the first or second round. That is how you have to go phase by phase. Otherwise, there will be a lot of confusion. You should not get confused. And you must have a clear mind and an elder sitting by you whenever you are completing the application process. So these are all different phases, which is allowed, which is not allowed. This again is available in the prospectus of UGs and PGs. Please remember, these are all the steps of the selection process. Application, then there will be a time period for scrutiny of the application by the selection committee, and they will be comparing the NEET score by climbed by the candidate, and they will be comparing with the real original scorecard from the National Testing Authority. Then some of the mismatch will be removed. Only the which are concurrent only with the which will be considered for preparation of the state merit list. Collecting data, they will be collecting data also from the school education, that takes time, and the sports authority, that takes time. Yet sorting, and that again we have to get the data from the army official and IRT, Institute for Road Transport. Then there is some quota available for the children of employees of the road transport, that they have to get it from the IRT, and persons with the disability. Here again, the medical certificate issued one day at the regional medical center. For Tamil Nadu, the regional medical center is the Madras Medical College. Rajiv Gandhi government, Rajiv Gandhi hospital only recognized medical board. No other medical certificate will be accepted either at the Tamil Nadu medical selection or at the medical counselling committee. So please remember, parents of the persons with a disability, you have to get the certificate only from them. Nowhere else. Then release of the merit list. After collecting all this data, after processing, the release of merit list for different courses will be released for MBBS and BDS combined together, the combined merit list. Then the paramedical courses are not, we will release it little later. And then online choice billing. Then what happens? Release of allotted applicants, repeat of second phase, third phase and fourth phase of counseling. This is the process of counseling. So 7.5, anybody remembers the number of seats available for last year? You remember?
473.
Yeah, excellent. Yeah, you are very alert, confident. Even at the pre-lunch session, you are alert. Okay, I'm just giving a trend. I'm not telling anything. For different categories, these are all for the 22-23 and 21-22. You can see the rise in the some of the things and follow the trend. I always think the cutoff mark is not necessary. The rank which the specific category is, because no two persons will have same rank, even if they have two ranks, two marks, similar marks, but the ranks will be definitely individualized. You more calculate the ranks by which you can predict. Don't rely on it. You rely on your mark. That's what I always believe that. This is for self-financing, government PDS and self-financing. financing, EDS. Okay, this is for the after post graduation. It may not be relevant right now for you because this is this thing I want to concentrate. Some of you might not scored well in the NEET, but still you want to pursue medical field. The medical field is not MBBS and BDS alone. Please remember, it's a teamwork. So teamwork requires other paramedical courses. For example, nursing. BSc nursing is there, and diploma nursing is also there. Post basic BSc nursing. BSc optometrist. For example, when you see the optic shops, it is manned by optometrist only. You can know the spectacle costs so much. The optometrist prescribes, and they are prescribing the spectacles. So such is a valuable course. And BPT, Bachelor of Physical Therapy. There are three government medical colleges available for, and in addition to self-financing colleges. Likewise, this is radiography, cardiopulmonary perfusion, and radiotherapy like that, B-Form, and Form-D courses are also available. So these are all different courses. The seats are based on the plus two marks. And depending upon the plus two marks only, the rank list will be given, and again counselling happens. You will be allotted depending upon the rank of the colleges. So please do not think that only MBBS and BDS are there. And these are all diploma courses. And these diploma courses are also meaning. So this is about the paramedical courses and certificate courses which are available. Now I am standing before you. For any interactive questions, I will be able to answer you possibly. Yeah, please. Please introduce yourself and tell me the question. If I know the answer, I will be able to tell you.
ஏன் நெல்லு கேளு, அப்பதான் மைக் கொடுப்பாங்க. ஏன் ஏதோ ஒன்று கேளு, மைக்
கொடுப்பாங்க. ரேங்க் If the NEET score is same, if the NEET score is same, what is the way in which the student is ranked?
If the NEET score is ready?
Same. Similar. If the NEET score is similar, what is the way in which the ranking is done?
Actually, for one single mark, there may be 100,000 candidates may be there. Mm-hmm. So they will be ranking as per the guidelines. The NEET score ranking is very important. Marks, not marks alone. The rank will be there. Depending upon the rank,
your state rank
also follows.
Individual candidates
will have different ranking.
உனக்கு என்ன தோணுதோ நீ கேளு.
The score marks are different. Yeah, individual is more. Out of that, am I clear to your answer?
Yes, sir. If the she is a pure science student, if
I am not the expert for the preparation of NEET. So tomorrow there is a session called cracking the NEET and the JEE. So they will be able to answer it better. But after getting the NEET score, only my role play comes into play here. So I may not be guide you for that. That is the one point.
Just one more question.
Yeah, please.
I've heard some people say that 10th and NEET exam marks also play a role in getting a seat. Is that true?
No. Only MBBS and BDS is only based on NEET.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Somebody else.
Hello.
Yeah.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Rajesh has completed a position at this year.
Congratulations, sir.
Preparing for the NEET very normally.
Okay, sir.
The only one question is that now you have shown that 36 medical colleges are available in Tamil Nadu,
yes,
government
sir.
Colleges. We are targeting for that government colleges only.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the comparison between MNC taking the seats in 2022? Our government has opened almost 8 colleges, how the lecturers are available, how the teaching facilities are available, how the experience which is gaining in MMC and gaining in recent newly opened colleges, even some of the colleges in their constructing, the construction is going on. Can I choose, is it in government colleges, what is your suggestion, and how the teaching, mainly I want to understand that how the teaching facilities are available.
Okay, sir, since I have worked in Madras Medical College as a professor of medicine and assistant professor, in Stanley Medical College as a professor of medicine, at Kilpauk Medical College, right now I am the dean, previously I was the professor of medicine, as well as I worked in Raipata also, I worked in Chennai, I worked in Nidupura, I worked in Krishnagiri, I worked in Karur. What other colleges I have not worked? I have worked for all the colleges. What I feel is that teachers, as long as medical fraternity is concerned, we always prefer, the students prefer the peripheral colleges. Because only undergraduates are there. In Madras Medical College, undergraduate is there, postgraduate is there, paramedical courses. The time spent by the faculty to all these students are divided. So I always believe any student should prefer a less number of seats available in colleges. This is my personal opinion. Nothing related to any of the posts I am holding right now. So that is the personal. And also the number of, for example, 250 students. So whenever I take a class in 250 classes, I always number them. 79 please answer me. 85 days answer. I don't have a personal thing, but in general, but where there was only 75 candidates when I studied, I know them by name. So the students always prefer college which have a more number of students because the the faculty cannot catch them. That is another point. But I honestly believe teaching faculty are available in all the colleges.
Please
understand that. And none of the colleges are not in construction stage. All they have completed the construction.
In 11th standard, no solid. In 11th standard, no solid.
So you can choose any college which is closer to your comfort of transport, where you can see your child. Where instead of, I remember one child preferred a Kilpauk Medical College. After that only they were calling me to transfer to Karur Medical College. Because the child is not able to acclimatize to the climate existing in Kilpauk because the candidate had a teething problem. So likewise, you must personally choose the college according to the child's needs. That is always better. That is the suggestion.
On the question, I next year.
Yeah, very clear, very clear. Only one question.
Yeah,
can I credit the past percentages on the website, like recently opened to colleges and compared to the MMC? Can I
get
the past percentages?
That is not published there, sir. It is not published. Not published there. So, as long as undergraduate is concerned, failing is very difficult. Okay. Passing is much easier. But please, as a plus two student, you understand. Medical curriculum is totally different.
Yes.
You have to read by yourself. My previous speaker was telling there was no faculty but the student got very good scores. Here we encourage self-directed learning because our books are our patients. Yes. Our books are our anatomy bodies. Our books are the skeletons. Nothing more than that. Yeah, these are the things.
I was thinking of doing psychology, my undergrad, postgrad and PhD in psychology. I was thinking about the scope for psychology and I was wondering if biology was really necessary.
படிக்க ஆரம்பிக்கும் போது அந்த அண்டர் கிராஜுவேட் போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேட்
சைக்காலஜி சைக்காலஜி இன் மை காலேஜ்
ஆக்சுவலி பயாலஜி இஸ் லைக் ப்ரிஃபர்ட் யூ கேனாட் சே இட்ஸ் அ மஸ்ட் பிகாஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கோர்சஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் திங்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் ஈவன் ஐஐடி இஸ் கொலாபரேட்டிங் வித் இந்தியா யூனிவர்சிட்டி டு மேக் அ பயோமெடிக்கல் கோர்சஸ் வெரி reasonable. I am, as our previous speaker was telling, the, in future, the both medicine and the engineering will come together in most of the courses. So don't worry about that. Please read the process.
This is some of the money cake. Course,
that's it. Courses, for psychological courses, it's a little different. Please read the
studying class 11. There seems to be a boom in artificial intelligence and data science, and my friends are choosing that courses. So, will that impact medicine?
Definitely,
some way.
Definitely. But we call it as an augmented intelligence. There is no artificial intelligence. Our human brains are intelligence. So, we call it always an augmented intelligence, not an artificial. So, you have to apply. Whatever may be, there should be somebody behind operating.